Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's jump right in and learn how to name haloalkanes or halogenated alkanes. Now, the prefixes that we use to bring halogens in as groups, they're written in the upper left. So fluorine is a fluoro group, chlorine is chloro, bromine is bromo, and iodine is iodo. All the molecules we're going to deal with on this slide are heptanes. They're all going to have seven carbon chains. The top one I've written here, that's carbon 1 through carbon 7. And we're going to, in this case, start numbering on the left because we have an iodo group on our chain, and we want to number the chain so that our branch point occurs on as early a carbon as possible. And so that means that we're going to number from the left. And so the iodo group sits on carbon 3. And so we say 3 iodo heptane. Note again, when we have numbers and letters with each other, we have to separate them by a dash or a hyphen. Okay, for the second molecule, also going to be heptane. Note that we're going to start numbering this one on the right because that will give us our branch point for chlorine on carbon 2 instead of having the methyl group three carbons deep on the chain. So we'll start on the right with chlorine. Now we have two groups. It's going to be heptane, but we have two groups, chlorine and methyl, chloro and methyl. Chlorine comes first because it is alphabetically first. So it's 2-chloro. And what is this going to be? 2-3-4-5. 5-methyl. Heptane. So here we have a mix of halo groups, a halo group, and an alkyl group, a methyl. The next problem is very similar. In fact, it's the exact same molecule. All we've done is add a bromine, a carbon 4. Now, bromine has a higher number, a higher position number, but alphabetically it comes before the chloro or methyl. So we start with the bromo. 4-bromo, 2-chloro, 5-methyl. And again, using those dashes or hyphens to separate our letters and numbers. And this is all one long word. There are no spaces in here. Typically, our names won't have any spaces in them. Now, lastly, we have another heptane. We're going to number from the left because our branch point is on carbon 2 with these two fluorines. And so we have two fluorines, and we have an ethyl, and that's going to be at carbon 4. So ethyl comes before fluoro, so we'll say 4-ethyl. Now the two fluorines, we have to give them both position numbers, and we use a difluoro. So this would be 2-2-difluoroheptane. Oops. And that's this last molecule. Note that we have the di to indicate if you have two numbers, you have to say that there are going to be two groups, and you indicate that by saying difluoro. And when we alphabetize the fluoro, we alphabetize it as F, not with the D in di. So those are some simple halogens. They're very easy to incorporate once you know how to incorporate other groups, like alkyl groups.